Hi, I'm Taronish. I'm going to highlight some of the new features in the Target and Target for ArcGIS 2012 release. Updates to Target and Target for ArcGIS make it even easier to incorporate 3D visualization into your everyday exploration workflow. We've streamlined menus and boosted the capability to integrate 2D and 3D data with simple drag-and-drop functionality. In previous versions of Target and Target for ArcGIS, you had to add slices of 3D objects, such as DXF files, to your section maps one at a time. Now you can plot 3D vector file slices to your section maps directly from the Map Parameter dialog box, allowing you to create multiple maps with slices of your 3D objects in a few simple clicks. Before, the 2D MXD environment of Target for ArcGIS prohibited you from exporting objects in your section maps to true 3D space in the 3D viewer. Now, with Target for ArcGIS, you can easily digitize interpretations and drawings in your 2D section map and export them to the 3D viewer with correct spatial referencing. With Target version 7.5 and Target for ArcGIS version 3.5, you can now drag and drop 2D map layers into the 3D viewer. Workflows are more streamlined than ever, allowing you to save time making maps and spend time interpreting the data. We've also added the inverse distance weighted gridding algorithm to both Target and Target for ArcGIS, allowing you to grid your geological data in 3D with a faster alternative to kriging. Previously, you were able to clip your 3D view spatially along the X, Y, and Z axes. Now, you're free to clip along any plane with any dip and azimuth. Use this new functionality to clip your 3D view along a known fault plane or a zone of mineralization. Are you working with a lot of projects? With Target version 7.5, you can access up to 16 recently opened projects, allowing you to get started even faster than before. Thank you for viewing this video. To see all the new features in Target and Target for ArcGIS, visit www.geosoft.com.